Welcome to Allprint Supply's how-to video demonstrating vehicle wrapping basics and how to successfully apply a vehicle wrap. The techniques shown in this video will demonstrate the key principles to successfully plan and apply wrapping vinyl for vehicle wraps. What's the difference between a partial vehicle wrap and a full wrap? Only the way you lay out your vinyls in the stage prior to adhering your printed graphics to the van. The planning and techniques you will use to apply a vinyl wrap remain the same. The tools you will need are cleaning products, clean, soapy water and U-Pol anti-silicon degreaser, lint-free wipes, clean sharp retractable knife scalpel, spare sharp scalpel blades, magnetic holders for vinyl positioning, low-tack application tape for vinyl positioning, a tape measure, 1 4-inch ribbed squeegee with clean velvet edge with replacement velvet strips, clean low lint white nylon gloves, an infrared laser digital thermometer and a 2000 watt hot air gun. Planning your artwork. The design will need to fit the specific vehicle you are applying the vinyl onto. There are many different vehicle manufacturers and vehicles come in all shapes and sizes dependent on manufacturer and model. You will need to use accurate vehicle panel templates of the specific vehicle model you are designing for. This will enable you to effectively create the design and to work out the optimum use of your printed vinyls in order to cover the van with minimum waste. Templates are available from manufacturers and specialists. Alternatively, you can use a digital camera and careful use of a tape measure to accurately capture the different panels and contours of the specific vehicle model you are designing for. Check the size of your printed vinyl sheets and that they are optimised to cover the intended vehicle surface. Your design must effectively consider the creases and contours of the vehicle. Carefully consider where any overlapped vinyl areas and joins are to be made when planning in this design stage. Try to avoid using printed text within your designs either above the rain gutters or below the bottom swages, as these areas can be more prone to stretching while fitting, with the possibility of then appearing out of shape. We would recommend you use CAD cut vinyls for text elements and apply these on top of the vinyl design afterwards. Leave enough bleed where vinyls are joined on the vehicle surface and try to plan joins in areas of the vehicle such as in rain gutters or in the swages or panel edgings. A 20mm overlap should be enough. Work out your design so it fits the vehicle and then allow yourself a minimum extra 3 inches of printed graphic running off all edges of the van to ensure you won't run out of film whilst applying the vinyls. You don't want to leave any areas unintentionally not covered with vinyl. If you come up short during application, you've ruined your wrap. Avoid unnecessarily complicated designs, as making joins between complex patterns as you wrap vinyls around the corners of your vehicle are very hard to line up correctly when applied around the van 360 degrees. Always show your designs to the fitter prior to printing so they can give you guidance and input onto what designs will work and which will not be practically achievable. Planning and choosing the right vinyl. Make sure you use the right vinyl for the right type of application. Consider longevity and durability for the conditions it will be used in. Use a laminate to protect the printed graphic, ensuring the laminate is of the same grade as the printed vinyl. There's no point using a 10-year printed vinyl and a 2-year laminate if the job is expected to last 10 years. As wet application of most car wrapping vinyl is not an option, you should ideally use an air-free repositional adhesive so you can more easily adjust the position of your vinyl during application. A note about environment and ambient temperature. Vinyl wraps should be performed in a stable temperature environment within 15 to 25 degrees Celsius, but always check the vinyl's data sheet for specific application guidelines for the vinyl that you are using. Vinyl wraps should be performed within a temperature managed environment free of dust and dirt, ideally in a workshop studio with plenty of room to work in. If wrapping in hotter temperatures, the adhesive will become more grabby, so less manageable when repositioning the graphic on the surface, and in colder temperatures is less likely to retain a successful adhesion. Be aware, rapid changes in temperature can cause what is called thermal shock, leading to failure of the vinyl. We would generally recommend you leave a wrapped vinyl within the same environment at a consistent temperature for at least 24 hours to allow it to settle before going out on the road. If vehicle wrapping in colder weather, do not let the vehicle leave the workshop until the following day. The vehicle and vinyl should be allowed to cool down at the same rate as the workshop. This will help to avoid thermal shock and reduce the risk of failure in the recesses. Pre-application, planning wraps that will cover larger surface areas. For areas of large vinyl coverage, work in pairs, as handling large sheets of vinyl will be unmanageable by one person. Prior to application, you will need to completely position your printed graphics around the vehicle, using magnets or masking tape to hold the vinyl sections in place. This is to ensure patterns are accurately aligned as they follow the contours of the surface around the whole vehicle before you start application. By laying out the vinyl in this way, you can check your printed vinyl sections are correctly optimised to cover the intended surface of the van with enough graphic bleed off of the edges. It will also help you correctly align where the design will need to overlap and where the vinyl sections need to be joined so as not to leave areas unintentionally uncovered. You don't want to find you've made a mistake and run out of printed film whilst in the middle of applying the vinyl. Planning of the artwork prior to adhesive installation is essential to minimise waste of your vinyl and to minimise the joins between the vinyl sheets. Planning where joins will overlap on the surface will help reduce effects of wind shear and other environmental factors that can influence the longevity of the vinyl adhesion. Joins should ideally be hidden in rain gutters, panel breaks, recesses or swages in the panels. Vinyl should be applied from the back of the vehicle to the front and top to bottom to ensure your vinyl application will be least affected by environmental conditions such as rain, wind and dirt getting driven into joins. Pre-application, cleaning the vehicle. Thoroughly clean all the surfaces the material is to be applied to using a sponge and clean soapy water. Degrease the vehicle using isopropyl alcohol, or alternatively a fast drying panel wipe with silicone killer. We recommend you spray the surface with water first and then pour isopropyl alcohol onto a clean lint-free cloth to wipe the surface clean of remaining grease. Don't forget to pay special attention to all the recesses such as in door frames. Oil, grease and any dirt left on the bodywork will affect the material's adhesion to the surface. Application. Planning the vinyl positions on the vehicle. Make sure you have a printed version of the complete design to hand and refer to it often to ensure you are following the layout of the design. Carefully position the vinyl where the design dictates and initially fix the vinyl position with magnets. Then measure any discernible elements to double check and triple check the position of the design and that the vinyl is going to be applied accurately and straight. If you get the positioning wrong, it will become more obvious as you apply vinyl around the vehicle, and this is especially true on full wraps. With the vinyl in position, create a hinge using low-tack application tape, ensuring the hinge tape is placed on a flat part of the surface. To make application more manageable, only remove the liner in small sections to prevent unwanted pre-sticking to the surface. This also allows you more rigidity in handling the graphic until it comes to actually apply to the intended area. When cutting the liner off, always cut the liner away from the vehicle surface so as not to scratch or damage the paintwork. Remove the unwanted portion of liner and ensure no debris such as paper dust or bits from the liner are left behind, which may get caught up in the exposed adhesive side of the vinyl. If you leave contaminants that find their way onto the adhesive, this will create a poor, uneven finish and also affect final adhesion properties of the vinyl to the surface. With the adhesive side exposed, pull the vinyl up tightly into position with no creases, buckling or excessive vinyl stretching, and provisionally tack it into position at the top of the vinyl. Stretch the vinyl without any heat over the area you are about to work on. Now use a hard squeegee that has a clean, soft strip of velvet on one edge. Remember to change the velvet regularly to avoid scratching the vinyl. Hold your squeegee at a 30 degree angle to the surface and use sideways motions with your squeegee, aiming to keep the adhered part of the vinyl as level as possible as you work the exposed vinyl into the surface. If you find you must cut through the vinyl on the bodywork, such as on hinges or around handles, it is best to stick electrical tape to the surface first. Always use a new blade each and every time you cut through the vinyl. The weight of the blade should be enough without having to apply extra pressure. You may need to peel back areas of vinyl as you go and re-stretch back into position to help get any buckles, creases or excessive trapped air out of the vinyl. Work your way downwards, keeping your squeegee strokes fairly parallel with the floor, and lightly stretch each next portion of vinyl into position onto the surface as you go. Always pull outwards from the largest area of the vinyl so that you can spread the tension and keep the vinyl as flat as possible to the surface. Avoid trapping air when working in the vinyl with your squeegee. So work from the centre, purposefully pushing the vinyl outwards towards the edges of the vinyl with enough pressure so as to push any air out, avoiding creating hard creases where you ruck up the vinyl, as this can be very hard to fix, even with expert use of extra heat. Take great care not to distort the graphic when stretching the vinyl into position or when you're using heat. Do not work the film into the more complicated areas such as recesses until later. For now, simply apply the vinyl flat over any complicated or recessed areas. If you find you have overstretched the vinyl a little, you can very easily reconform the vinyl back to its original shape with careful use of a small amount of heat from a heat gun. Apply heat to a larger area than you need, as this should help to avoid distorting the graphic. Use a digital thermometer to ensure you only use between 40 to 50 degrees Celsius heat, or you may damage the vinyl. Ensure the material is fixed firmly to all edges of any irregular shapes in the surface. Wear your gloves and work your way around the edges of all irregular shapes, dips and corrugations, ensuring all the edges are fixed very firmly. If you find air bubbles under your vinyl after application, then make a very small pinprick with a sharp scalpel blade at the very edge of the bubble and push out the air from the opposite side of the pinprick towards the hole to ensure all air is removed and the vinyl is now completely stuck to the vehicle surface with no trapped air. Once all edges have been firmly fixed to the surface, the application of the material in the recesses and shaped surface areas can begin. To conform the recessed and irregular shaped areas, use a hot air gun to heat these areas of material gently to about 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. We advise you only heat small areas at a time. Always check the correct temperatures are adhered to using a temperature sensor. Having heated the material to 40 to 50 degrees Celsius, use your gloved hand to start stretching the material into the deepest parts of the recessed bodywork. Ensure the area of material you're working on stays heated to at least 40 degrees Celsius, and, focusing only on the deepest parts of the recess at first, continue gently pushing and stretching the vinyl all the way around the recessed area. Remember, always leave an escape gap for the air to be pushed out from and close this area off only after the entire recessed area has been successfully adhered to the surface, leaving behind no trapped air. Once the deepest parts have been successfully applied, begin to work your way through all the other areas in the recessed contours, shaping the material into the contours of the substrate. Again, ensure that the material is heated to 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. With all the edges now properly applied, you will need to turn your attention to the remaining areas of the vinyl, such as the part you left for the air to escape from. Finally, trim off the excess areas of vinyl which are not required, such as around edges of bodywork on hinges and between doors. The vinyl edges need to be tucked tidily away behind bodywork trim areas, so when trimming off these areas, leave an excess of a couple of millimetres to wrap around the edges of the doors. Work the vinyl into these edges to both hide and help protect the edges of the vinyl. Reattach any furniture and fixings that you may have removed from the vehicle, such as badges or rubber edging and window trims. Finally, look all over the vinyl very carefully for any trapped air bubbles you may have missed, and check that all vinyl and edges are properly adhered to the surface of the vehicle. If any small air bubbles can still be seen, these are easily removed with a small puncture at the edge of the bubble. Then heat it a little and push the air out. Now for the final stage. Use the hot air gun to heat or cook the material to approximately 80 to 90 degrees Celsius, ensuring you do not heat to above 100 degrees Celsius as this will damage the vinyl. Don't guess at getting the right temperature. Always use a reputable infrared laser digital thermometer to measure the amount of heat you're applying to the vinyl. You only need to focus on those areas where the material has been stretched into the recessed and shaped areas. Heating should be done gently by gradually increasing the temperature. It is important that the film and the substrate reach these temperatures by reheating gently rather than with short blasts of heat. Remove any remaining trapped air using a sharp scalpel and a little heat. Finally, wipe over the whole vinyl application with water and isopropyl alcohol to remove any handprints and marks to leave the vinyl looking clean and presentable. Practice and skill are required to become a good vinyl wrapper. It is extremely unlikely anyone can become an expert overnight. But with proper planning, patience and perseverance, anyone can become adept at wrapping vinyls. We hope you have found this basic demonstration video useful. And if you have any questions, please contact our sales offices and we will be glad to offer any advice as to attending wrapping courses or choosing the right materials for your vinyl wraps.